Cayman and Compass sports journalist CIFA Russell Jr. here at the Compass building. Join with the Cayman Islands Football Association president, Mr. Alfredo Whittaker. Mr. Whittaker, we are here today to speak about an unfortunate situation that occurred on Sunday night that has really left the entire country in shock, if you will. A mass shooting of the source, as some people refer to it as. First time in Cayman history that anybody has opened fire in an area that is surrounded by dozens of people, hundreds of people, if you will, kids, parents, all sorts of... the situation has really taken the island by storm, and I just want to get your immediate thoughts on it. We haven't heard from you on this situation. Obviously, you were dealing with the under-20s in St. Kitts and Nevis.
Well, I'm still shaking from it, and I wasn't there. So I could just imagine the spectators, family members, kids that was there, what they're feeling right now. Unfortunately for us, it happened in Cayman. It circled in the world. We had received many letters from FIFA, from CONCACAF, members associations from around the world, expressing their support and the disbelief of what happened in Cayman. We as an association, we had an emergency meeting where we came up with some decisions in conjunction with the police that obviously have this as an open investigation. And I guess everyone know by now that all football activities in the Cayman Islands for this week, we're not sure about next week, has been postponed or canceled. So we're trying to recover, we're trying to make contacts with the people that are involved. But as this being an open investigation, right, we have our limitations.
100%. And of course, you referred to the Football League being on hold. I believe the General Secretary said that it's on hold until March 5th. But of course, that can change. I wonder where you think or why you think this situation happened, without getting into too much details, obviously, because it is an ongoing investigation into the matter. But what would give any human being the incentive to go and open fire during a football match?
Well, that's a very difficult question, Russell. And I really don't have the answer for it. But there is a number of things that we have to look into. At this time, we're not sure who are the person or persons that are involved with it. I would say that we have to make a pause in our normal life that at some point is not as normal, and go wind back a little bit and start to see where we start to fail. Right? When we have this kind of situation that is taking place in our small country, there must be something where we went wrong. It could be as parents, it could be as grandparents, it could be as government, it could be of the many, many sports entities that we have in Cayman. We have after school program that we know, and it come from there. So in other countries it's a normal something, for us it's not a normal something. So maybe we fail somewhere, and it's never too late. We have a new generation that is coming up. Let's try to stop failing and let's try to correct our mistakes. But this have to be hand in hand with the sports entities, and unfortunately, in this case government, and all of those rich people that had moved to the island, it's time to start to contribute in something else and not just living and sucking from off us.
I hear you on that. And you know, I spoke with a coach earlier this week who sort of echoed what you are saying right now in terms of how much money is actually being pumped in to the youth. And I wonder if you think that the government can do a little bit more, not just for the Cayman Islands Football Association, but for the clubs, who many of their members really try to get a lot of these boys off the streets and give them a better life and give them some purpose through football. Do you think that the government can do more to support the clubs as well as the association?
100%, right? I'm not selfish in this matter. We should have every single club in the Cayman Islands should have a sports program. And every single one of those programs should be supported by the Ministry of Sports. We should really have a massive recruitment of every single child in the Cayman Islands, regardless if you have ham and cheese for breakfast, and some that don't have the cheese but only have the ham, or some that don't have the ham but only have the cheese. We shouldn't look at that. We should look at the welfare of our island, the welfare of our kids. The future of the Cayman Islands should be Caymanians. But at this point, the future of the Cayman Islands, we're looking somewhere else. We're completely overpowered. And when you talk about these things and you touch some little cut, it hurt too much, and then you're going to have people coming at you. Mm-hmm. And you have to be careful, but the truth is the truth. We had failed. Big companies that had moved to Cayman, big rich people had moved to Cayman. Not only the government. The government haven't given them that responsibility and say, because you're coming in with XYZ amount of million of dollars, your monthly, yearly, or weekly contribution towards this discipline of sports is XYZ. We haven't looked into that. We just make them come in and they do as wish. We should have the most ambitious and the most prosperous program, sports program. Mm-hmm. I'm not talking only about football here. All sports programs, we should have the most ambitious program here because of the people that we had allowed to come in here.
I agree. And obviously, nothing like this has ever happened in Cayman, right? Let alone at a football match. And I wonder if this watershed crime that occurred will now hamper the sport on island in terms of players now fearing for their lives and maybe stepping away from the sport. I spoke to Virgil Seymour, head coach, the technical director over at Academy Sports Club. He said that he will be resigning from the sport at the end of the season because of this matter. And obviously, the fans, the spectators, they're also afraid of the unknown. Could this possibly be the start of something really drastic in terms of people leaving the sport?
No. I think situation like this should, obviously we have to learn from it. Mm. And obviously we have to get together now with the sports department, with the police force, and we have to look in a different way of the people entering our football matches. It used to be an open gate, mm-hmm. and everyone would walk in for free and enjoy the game, because that's what we wanted. We wanted people to come and enjoy the game. But I guess we have to put some measure in place, like everywhere else in the world, where spectators coming in, unfortunately, have to get pat down and have to go through a handheld metal detector. Some parts in some stadiums have to be blocked. Mm. some other parts of the stadium have to be bring up to grade. And this is where we go back, Seaford, and the people that we have here. We have so many extremely wealthy people here that they should have our stadium, all of our stadiums and playing fields up to par, where we shouldn't be afraid or fear of any situation.
But a lot of those fields are government owned, so it should actually be the government's responsibility to make the structures more safe. But
I agree with it. But the government are the one who are a government entity or part of the government are the one that granting these people to come to live and enjoy the beautiful Cayman Islands.
Yeah.
So there should be you should be paying something to society, and in this case should be sports.
Yeah. I would assume that the securing of the structures will probably be something that would be done down the line, but in the immediate future, could we see perhaps more security presence, maybe a security officer, a police could be on hand for some of these games moving forward?
Absolutely. We need to work with the police. We need to work with the security companies. Now when you go and you ask a security company to hire 6 or 7 officers for a couple hours, they want to give you some bills. Right? So maybe we could compromise, and I think we should compromise. The executive committee at CIFA and myself is something that I had always been concerned about, not only at the football matches, but also at CIFA. And it's time to implement it. It's time to ban completely alcohol in the venues. We have situation where you could smell the odor of drugs. We have to eradicate that. And we have to make football and all sports in Cayman an enjoyable place to be. At the end of the day, is our one number one distraction that we have, to go and enjoy a good weekend of football, or a good weekend of track and field, a good weekend of swimming. I'm not jealous of the other sports. I just want our island to be a free and happy sports island.
You know, I want to go back to the interview that I did with Virgil yesterday. One of the things that he said that was very interesting was he believes that a lot of these crimes happen based on location. And he said that he would not be bringing his team to play any games in West Bay anymore. And he also referenced Boden Town. Do you think that areas and locations make a difference when it comes to these things, these kind of crimes occurring?
I would say yes and no. It's unfortunate that we always have situation in West Bay, and part of the field at Bush don't have the best light, especially where I guess by now everybody has seen the videos. In that section is pretty dark.
Yeah.
We don't have good lighting in that area. We don't have no deterrent in that area. So I could understand Coach Virgil's fear or concern. In Boden Town, same thing. Behind our two goals is a little dark, especially the one where you have the parking lot. And I could understand his fear. Now that we are talking about Mr. Virgil trying to step out of the sport, I think he needs to reconsider it. I personally would have a conversation with him, because what he have done in the life of many, many kids through sports is remarkable. And from the national team point stand, we have benefit largely, especially from the youth national teams, throughout his academy. And I really don't see the Academy Sports Club to be leaving or pausing because of this incident. He should stand strong and he should continue to do what he's doing, because it's a win-win situation for everyone. So I would have a conversation with him. We have discrepancies, we have little stuff, but at the end of the day, we've been good friends for many, many, many years.
Mm. Obviously, you touched on how you feel about the situation, and your belief is that this will not hamper the sport. And I want to know if the scene around you, you know, within the association, and just the football community as a whole, I'm sure that you've been receiving a ton of messages. What are some of the things that are people saying?
Most of them really concerned. Most of the message are being, what can we expect next? Mm. Most of the younger one, because we also receive calls from the 17s and 15s and 20-year-olds, they're kind of concerned about what should we expect, or if this is something that's going to continue to happen in our football games and activities. And my response to them is no. I strongly believe that this was an isolated incident. I strongly believe that, and I hope I'm wrong, right, that we would never have this and we should never experience this again. You have many of the spectators that was there that is still shaking pretty bad. We have a executive committee member that had just left there 15 minutes before it. We have another one that was sitting right there watching his son play, and some bullets went pretty close to him. Mm. We have other people that witness people getting shot, and it's a terrifying situation. For sensitive people like me, even though that sometimes I don't show it, even if you hit a chicken, you feel that thing, like, oh my God, right? I just hit a chicken. So just imagine watching people getting shot and dropping and running for their life. It's terrifying. It's really terrifying.
And you say running for your life, and it just made me think of a story that I heard from the incident. And I know that you said that this hopefully won't affect the attendance in the games, but certainly from a tourism aspect, from the outside looking in, this is not the kind of dark cloud you want hovering over the island. And I heard this story that there was a tourist in attendance at this game watching Cayman football for the first time, and that person ended up running out of the stadium with, I heard, a 2-year-old child in our arms running out of the stadium. And that story just gives me chills, because you know that that is the last, or her lasting impression of what this country is. And I wonder if you believe that tourism, sport and tourism, from a football perspective, is in jeopardy.
At this point, everything is in jeopardy, to be honest with you. It's fresh, it's right there in the memory of everyone, and like everything else, only time would heal this situation. I would just imagine myself if I would be there with my granddaughter. I probably would never go back to the stadium. I could imagine the feelings of the parents that every Saturday and Sunday go and enjoy game with the kids. And you could see when the first half finish, in every game you have all of these kids that go on the field and take a little 10, 12 minutes kick around with the football. And when the second game starts, you have even more kids. So I understand the situation with the tourists and the and what could or how it could affect the view of how you view the Cayman Islands. But and I don't want to sound bad here, my heart got more to the parents that was there, our people that was there, that every Saturday and Sunday they're there. Mm. And they have to live it and they went through it. And how it going to affect them if they would ever go back to the stadium, the kids, the 10, 7 or 8 year old kids, how they feeling at this point? That's what I need to know. Unfortunately, I don't know it. Unfortunately, I haven't been able to, because I just got back on island a couple hours ago, and I haven't been able to identify any one of those kids that was there. I'm pretty sure we have also players of our U15 boys national team, girls national team. What is their view at it right now? Right, so that is my concern, and that's where the executive committee is trying to gather all of these players and have conversation with them and see what it is. Our senior men national team was about to start training today. Unfortunately, that is being postponed until next week, hopefully. So it's a lot of our local things, right? We need to take care of our house first, and then we go to other people's house.
Yeah.
So that's my concern right now. Our people and how they're looking at it, how they're feeling about it.
Yeah. Now, thankfully, no one passed away as a result of this matter. But I know that you guys have honored people who have passed away with a moment of silence before games. Will the association be doing anything to pay tribute to this horrific incident before the games restart?
This is a Memorial Day, and I don't want to jump in answers that may change, but there is some ideas for these days, for this particular day, and we have to sit down, we have to discuss it. Mm. Maybe no. We always have someone that have a better idea that would enhance it to make it a special day. But it's a day that we would never forget in the Cayman Islands. No. It's like that day when they told us that Hurricane Ivan would hit us as Category 5. That day we would never forget. It's like the Americans and the entire world, when they celebrate that September 11, they would never forget that. And this is one of those memorable days, unfortunately, in a bad way for us, that we would never forget.
Yeah.
It changed, and it will continue to change a lot of people's life. Fortunately, as you mentioned, there was no one to mourn. And we hope that everything, that the people that still in the hospital continue to recover. Mm. And we don't have to go through that.
Now, we're thin on time, and it's unfortunate that we have to meet under these circumstances, but is there any final thoughts that you would like to say on this situation before we wrap it all up?
Just for those that are in the hospital, family members, I want you all to know that the Cayman Islands Football Association and his entire executive committee have you in our prayers, have you in our thoughts. We constantly talking about the situation. We will make this a learning experience for all of us, right? For the entire Cayman Islands, and for those that really have Cayman at heart, let's make this place a better place. Help us to live better, since you decide to come and enjoy the peacefulness that we have. Let us work all together, and let's change the way of doing things and seeing things. And my last petition is for us to be better persons. It doesn't matter if you black or white or green or yellow or whatever, let us be a better person, and let us make the place where we decided to live a better place and a more enjoyable place.